Everyone has heard this term, carbon credit, and I'm not sure that everyone knows what it means. Can you help just unpack what is a carbon credit?
A carbon offset is 1 ton of negative carbon. There are two types of carbon markets in which carbon offsets or carbon emissions are traded. We have compliance markets, which are regulated by governments who are attempting to limit the total amount of emissions permitted within their borders. Each ton of permitted emissions is registered as a credit, and corporations can buy and sell these as needed. Voluntary carbon markets are driven by corporations who are choosing to reduce their carbon emissions and opt to use carbon offsets to net out against hard-to-abate emissions in their business. A lot of corporations are seeing the drive to fully decarbonize operations through a combination of moral imperative, but also the clear will of their customers and their employees.
They are facing pressure to decarbonize from their stakeholders. And in response to these pressures, many are choosing to make voluntary net zero commitments, promising to reduce their total carbon footprint to zero by a target date. However, it is quite difficult for these corporations to actually reduce their emissions to zero. Some of the technology to do this simply does not exist yet. So, after they've switched their electricity to solar and their fleets to electric vehicles and done everything else that available technology allows, they can purchase carbon offsets to net out their remaining hard-to-abate emissions.
People hear of like cap and trade, or almost think of a regulated carbon market as being this right to pollute. It's basically the government saying, you can pollute this much, and then firms can trade back and forth based on how productive the products they're making that's requiring that pollution require. Is that the right way to think about it?
It's an attempt to limit total carbon emissions within the system, but to allow for different actors to reduce their emissions on different trajectories and to be able to purchase additional emissions for those that they're not able to reduce within their operations. Over time, typically cap and trade markets reduce the total amount of emissions that are permitted within the system. So there's four key criteria that any carbon offset needs to meet. The first is additionality. The reduction must not have been possible without the sale of offsets. The second is permanence. The carbon that is being removed or reduced will remain that way and not be emitted at a later date. The third is leakage. Emissions reductions in one area must not lead to higher emissions elsewhere. And finally, measurability and tracking. The carbon reduction amount must be verified by an expert third party, and the record of the offset and its retirement must be maintained in a single registry.
Projects that generate negative carbon, either by avoiding emissions or by removing carbon dioxide from the air, can sell these offsets. They can then ultimately be purchased by a corporation who retires them to net out its emissions.
And yet, today, there's some problems with those markets. What are the problems today?
There is a great heterogeneity in types of carbon offsets that are offered.
The offsets vary by origination source. For example, they could be from avoided deforestation, or biochar, or direct air capture, as well as by geography and vintage. These offsets are sold in a very opaque market, primarily through brokers who charge extremely high fees. You have very limited price transparency, so it's hard to say what a fair price is. So, in summary, this is a very murky, nascent market with a lot of inefficiencies. And because of how murky this market is, we've seen instances of very poor quality projects, ones which did not actually meet the abatement criteria which they claim to, take advantage of this and lead to questions about the credibility of the market as a whole.
But so what this translates to is an incredibly inefficient financial market that right now is really serving neither side of the equation. What we need to move to is from an over-the-counter market to a true, liquid, high-quality financial market. And that market needs to be built on trust and transactability and liquidity.
To get there, what do we need?
So there's a few key components that need to fall into place. First is we need greater standardization of securities of the offset.
Buyers should be able to know exactly what they are getting on all parameters which matter to them and be able to easily locate it without needing to call 10 brokers and without needing to do significant, expensive, and time-consuming due diligence on the underlying project.
The second thing we need is greater liquidity within these markets. And additionally, we need a very high caliber of verification and trust of information that's conveyed. For now, it's likely that this will need to be a self-regulating mechanism or through a trusted third party that verifies the information provided by the carbon offset developer.
Is what we're rooting for, that these carbon markets become so sophisticated, that there's more diversity in the underlying securities and therefore the sources of the underlying negative carbon.
I think what we're rooting for is that there is enough types of standardized carbon offset categories such that all of the buyers of these carbon offsets are able to find what they're looking for based on the criteria which are important to them.
With enough transparency on types of offsets, but more importantly on quality of offsets, we hope that buyers will be able to buy exactly what they need at a known price, and sellers will be able to have higher certainty in carbon prices and finance the development of new projects. We hope to see more project capital flow into the space to finance build-out of new high-quality projects. And we hope to see a transparent, liquid carbon market drive a flight to quality and an increase in adoption.
Sometimes in and around climate change, there's this paradox of, in some ways, financial markets got us into this problem, and yet carbon markets are another financial market. They're an instantiation of capitalism. Why do we need a market for negative carbon?
The latest projections from the IPCC state that it is basically impossible for us to reach our climate goals as a planet without carbon sinks. And the best way for us to enable carbon sinks and to enable the creation of the technologies and the project structures and the developers that will need to exist in 10, 20 years for that to be the case mean that the financial markets, the carbon markets, need to enable the creation of this in order for us to start the groundwork now for us to reach those climate goals.
In the absence of a full global regulation on emissions reduction, which unfortunately is highly unlikely, a functioning financial market is the best framework we have to allocate capital and create a negative carbon economy.
So a lot of what I've heard you say is that we need better infrastructure. It's like we need better plumbing to support these absolutely critical carbon markets. And there's a lot to that. How do we get there?
So we're gonna need an enormous amount of new companies to be built that address all of the portions of this market. We need traders, market makers, verification engines, funds, ETFs, all of the pieces that exist within a traditional financial market will need to be created for the voluntary carbon market. Great businesses will be built on the back of this market, and we are eager to invest in all pieces of this ecosystem in order to help drive the market forward.
In addition to this, we need to see a significant increase in the supply of carbon offsets to ensure that the growing demand can in fact be met. Right now, access to capital can often be a barrier to building projects which generate carbon offsets, which means that in addition to the financial market infrastructure to support the transactions between supply and demand, we will need to see a significant mobilization of project level capital to enable an increase of high quality supply.
Well, I could not be more excited to be hopefully finding some of those companies and investing in them and supporting the growth of this really critical market. But thank you so much for sharing your thoughts on carbon credits and the whole ecosystem.